I'm Mary Tooley Parker. This is my studio in Northern Westchester. It's small, as you can see, but it serves the purpose. I have lots of hand-dyed wool in every color. This is hand-spun wool that I spun on my spinning wheel. And this is my frame, which is a frame from Teddy Camp, Nova Scotia, that I do all my work on. I first saw the stunning quilts of G's Bend, Alabama, at the Whitney Museum in 2002. The exhibit went on to tour the country, and many of them are now owned by museums, including 10 recently purchased by the Metropolitan Museum in New York. I was deeply moved by the exhibit, not only by the visual impact of the quilts, but also by the utilitarian materials used to make them. They were examples of the make-do traditions of great folk art, where the maker works with what is on hand with the simplest of tools and creates art. G's Bend quilts are immediately recognizable and are widely acclaimed as art, but the individual quilters themselves are rarely seen or mentioned. The quilts are not all the same, and neither are the quilters who made them. In this series, created over the past 10 years, I wanted to highlight some of the older quilters whose quilts were really unique and striking, to give them the recognition and respect they deserve as artists. So these are the tools. This is the hook, very simple, a scissors, and my backing on my frame. And I just use the hook to pull a cut wool strip up through the backing like this. And you just keep pulling up the loops. And that's it. And you can go in any direction. And that's how it's done.